Hello students, I am Irfan Raza. Today we are going to discuss the first chapter of class 10th English literature book First Flight, and the name of the chapter is A Letter to God, written by G.L. Fuentes. Introduction of the story. This is a story of a Latin American farmer named Lencho. Lencho writes a letter to God seeking help from him as his entire crops destroyed by hailstorm. Actually, the main idea of this story revolves around unquestionable belief in God. So, let us find out what happens actually in this story. Here it is. The story begins with description of Lencho's house. The house of Lencho is situated on the top of a low hill, and this is the only house in the entire valley. From there, Lencho is able to see the river and his own field of ripe corn, which is dotted with flowers, which is a sign of good harvest of corn crops. Here, corn crops means the crop of maize. The only thing that Lencho awaited was rainfall. In this hope, he was continuously looking towards the northeast sky since morning and expecting a good shower on his field. Lencho said to his wife that he is quite confident to get rain. His wife was preparing dinner and replied, "Yes, but by the grace of God." Their children were working at the field. The younger one were playing near the house when Lencho's wife called everyone for dinner. It was during dinner time when finally the big drops of rainfall started and Lencho's prediction comes true. Huge mountains of clouds can be seen approaching from northeast direction. The air was fresh and sweet, indicating pleasant and desired rainfall. Lencho went out of the house to feel the pleasure of droplets on his body. And when he returned back to his house, he addressed raindrops as coins and said big drops are 10 cents and the smaller one 5 cents. In Indian language, we can understand that Lencho was comparing big raindrops with 10 rupees coin, while the smaller one as 5 rupees coin. The reason behind was these raindrops would ensure a good and surplus crops by which Lencho will get a lot of money. Now Lencho is very happy and satisfied and regarded his field covered with droplets which resembled as if they were wrapped in a curtain. But unexpectedly, a strong wind began to blow, leading to a hailstorm. The writer compares these hailstorms as silver coins, and Lencho's children ran outside to play and collect pieces of ice, referred to as frozen pearls. Now Lencho easily understood that whatever is happening, this is very bad, and expecting that the storm gets over quickly. But unfortunately, it continued, and after an hour, the entire valley covered with snow, as if a layer of salt placed on the house, the garden, the hillside, and the cornfield. This was a very sorrowful moment for Lencho, as the hailstorm destroyed the entire corn field and the valley. Lencho's soul was crying. He was standing in the middle of the field after the storm and saying to his sons, "The effect of the storm proved to be worse than that of crop destroying insects," means locust. He was helpless and feared that they might have to starve this year. It was a very painful night for the whole family, as their hard work had gone in vain. They all were very much restless. But the family still had hope in their hearts. They had faith in God. Lencho supported his family members by assuring that no one will die of hunger or starvation. The entire night, Lencho was only thinking of to seek the help of God. Lencho had blind faith in God and knew that God knows everything, even what is hidden in deep conscience of a living being. Lencho was a hard-working farmer and spent all his time in the field, yet he knew how to write. Next Sunday morning, he wrote a letter to God and decided to mail it himself by going to the town. In his letter to God, he described his bad situation and requested 100 pesos to reproduce the crops. Here, pesos refer to currency of Latin American countries. On the envelope, he wrote, "To God," placed a stamp on the letter and dropped it in the mailbox. A postman, who was also an employee of the post office, showed that letter to the postmaster. Who is postmaster? A person who is in charge of the post office. And here, description of postmaster has been given, that he was a fat and friendly natured man. He first started laughing, but immediately he became serious and surprised at the amount of faith Lencho had in God. Finally, the postmaster decided to reply Lencho that he must have a strong bonding with God. But when postmaster opened the letter, he understood that the writer could not be fulfilled with pen, paper and sympathy. But he stuck to his decision. He, along with his colleagues, collected a pool of money for a good reason. Despite his best effort, the postmaster was not able to collect 100 pesos. It was only a little more than half, means more than 50 pesos. He kept the money in an envelope and signed by God. Next Sunday, Lencho arrived a bit earlier to receive his letter. The postmaster handed him the letter, waiting to see his happiness and satisfaction. On the contrary, Lencho did not show the slightest surprise or happiness on seeing the money. Why? Because he had blind faith in God, and he was 100% sure that whatever he demanded from God, God will never turn down his request. Although he got disheartened when he counted the money, because he thought that God cannot make a mistake of sending less amount. Very soon, Lencho decided to write another letter to God and started looking for ink and paper. He used public writing table to write the letter. When he was writing, his eyebrows wrinkled due to anger. When he completed, he affixed a stamp on the envelope with a blow of his fist. This was a token of anger. As soon as he dropped the letter into the mailbox, the postmaster took it out and read it. Lencho complained that he had received only 70 pesos and demanded to God to resend the remaining amount as he is really in need of it. This time, he suggested God not to send money through post as he doubted the integrity and honesty of the post office employees. He understood that the staff at the post office must have stolen his 30 pesos and called them a group of cheaters. So, in this way, we completed the story. Now, what is the moral of the story? One should have faith in God. That is very good and that should be. But at the same time, one should also trust one's fellow human beings. It is ironic that most of us lack faith in one another. Lencho blames the very people for dishonesty who have helped him in reality. Thus, we come to an end of this chapter. Thank you for watching my video.